So for this week's Community Focus Friday, we're here at RIFA in Jackson, Tennessee. A very fitting time to do this video because Thanksgiving's coming up, Christmas is around the corner, and we've got a lot of people who are not going to be as fortunate as us during these holidays when it comes to food or when it comes to children receiving presents, and RIFA steps in and they are really good at helping out people in need. So we're gonna do a quick little video here and keep them in your mind during the holidays. Extra food, extra presents, bring them to RIFA. They will do a good deed with them. Let's jump straight in the video. So where is RIFA located? We're at 133 Airways Boulevard here in Jackson, Tennessee. So if you see right here, they've got a little thrift store. Take a quick look inside. You see, we've got a bunch of stuff at discount in here, pretty cheap. And now we're gonna go see if we can find someone to talk to us about RIFA, give us a little bit more information straight from the source. Go get a quick tour.
So the area where you came in is where all of our patrons who are in need of immediate food assistance will come. They will come, they will interact with our frontline receptionist. Our receptionist is so much more than just someone who answers phone calls. Mm-hmm. It is someone who is equal parts social worker, mind reader, air traffic controller, hall mm-hmm. monitor, and Ms. Mary told me last week, a train conductor. So what they are doing is they are assessing the need. Folks can get what we call a to-go bag or a convenience mm-hmm. bag. Sometimes hunger or food insecurity is just symptomatic of some other things that may be going on beneath the surface. Maybe they just lost a job. Maybe they were just evicted. Maybe they're dealing with a mental health crisis. Maybe there's addiction issues or a complex combination of all of those things. So our frontline folks help to discern that and assess that. Conversation needed, mm-hmm. they will meet with our social worker. We're kind of low staffed right now because our front desk person is at a family funeral and all the things. Mm-hmm. So our social worker who you met up front is Abby. So we just all do what we need to do to get things done.
And I heard the front desk lady, she was talking about breakfast. So y'all feed people breakfast.
Well, we will get to that. We have what are called our to-go bags. We have outreach bags of canned goods, dry mm-hmm. goods, and hygiene bags. So if people are interested in giving those kinds of items, we have Amazon wish lists that we can send you the links and give you the posts for. So those are very specific items that we're looking for.
Awesome.
We also have folks, rather than a pre-packed bag, mm-hmm. they can come in here and they can shop. Of course, shop is in air quotes. Because everything that you see in here is free to them, and everything that is here and that basically that you'll see in the rest of this building is here because of a donation.
Yeah, that's
whether
awesome.
Whether someone gave us a case of pinto beans or they gave us the money to mm-hmm. buy it. We also have food rescue partnerships with local restaurants. So places like Olive Garden, I have a volunteer that goes and picks up their surplus soups and pastas mm-hmm. every Monday. And so that's available to our Chose Pantry.
That's pretty awesome.
We also have, we get weekly donations from Kroger, Walmart, Aldi, Save A Lot. Mm-hmm. So that helps particularly with our perishable foods and meats and proteins and things like that. Patron portrait wall.
Uh-huh.
It's a beautiful wall in so many ways, but I think one of the things that I find most compelling about it is that it reminds us that everyone has a story.
Mm-hmm.
And also, too, that we are all made in the image of God with human as human beings mm-hmm. in value and worth and dignity. And so these are folks that are regular patrons of ours. Some of the stories I know, for example, Mr. Tommy. When I started volunteering here over a decade ago, he was our chief dishwasher. Mm-hmm. He is part of the RIFA family. RIFA is his family. He was an orphan, very young. Grew up with extended family, found himself in dire circumstances, found his way to RIFA, and became a volunteer and just kind of part of the fabric of the mm-hmm. family of RIFA.
That's pretty awesome.
And so there's so many folks that have stories like that. That's part. Whether it's a chair, a Barbie bike, a walker, clothing, toys and games, housewares, comes in through that door right there, and it gets sorted and organized into various categories. With our clothing, we do a quality check on those. We want to make sure that all the buttons button and the mm-hmm. zipper. There's no rips or tears or stains or anything like that.
Gotcha.
Some young ladies coming in to volunteer. that the toaster works. It doesn't just blow up when you put it on the counter.
On that note, how would you go about volunteering if somebody wanted to come here and volunteer?
Absolutely. It's a great question. So they would contact me. I'm the volunteer coordinator. They can look on our website. They can download the volunteer application. You fill out the application. You'll meet with me to get a tour of RIFA, and I'll share more about the mission. And then we'll sit down and do volunteer hour, you know, work out volunteer hours.
Gotcha.
Families are welcome. When I first started volunteering here in 2010, my boys were with me. They were 5 and 8.
They had fun.
We started off in the soup kitchen. Oh, they had a blast. They had a blast. They are now 19 and 22. And some of their fondest childhood and growing up years memories come from serving at RIFA. They served in the soup kitchen. We did snack backpacks. We did senior staples. My youngest did food sorting. And so when you come around the corner and out,
10,000 square foot warehouse.
Yes. We just had our construction event. And that is it's actually a national movement that organizations and businesses compete to build structures out of canned goods. It's not just like a little pyramid out of here. Like it's 12 by 12 structures with themes.
Yeah.
Amazing precision, patience, and technicality. And the beautiful thing about that is all of those canned good items get donated back to RIFA.
Gotcha. Okay.
So we literally have 23 tons in the building right now of canned goods.
Snack backpack program.
Snack backpack program. Every week we pack about 900 to 1,000 bags that go to our food insecure students in the Jackson-Madison County school system. This provides food over the weekend where children may not have it otherwise. It's got 6 meals in it, plus 2 snacks. We keep in very close contact with our guidance counselors at 13 different elementary schools. We have volunteers that pack, and then I have a set of volunteers that make sure that each school gets their requested amount each week. Juliana, head up to like the collaborative, and I can get you a flyer for it.
Oh, that'd be great.
So senior staples boxes, we do 300 boxes a month that go out to low-income seniors in our area and a little bit beyond our region, so we rotate that. We also have a grant-funded fresh produce delivery. We team up with Falcon Ridge Farms out of Zune, and that goes April to October. Actually, next Wednesday is our final delivery for the harvest season. We have a soup kitchen where folks can come and serve breakfast and lunch. We also serve evening meals, thanks to a group of rock star volunteers that coordinate that. There's a lot happening under the
street. I could tell. There's a lot going on over here.
I started out a volunteer 14 years ago. 30,000 volunteer hours were donated to RIFA last year, which we did a little bit of RIFA math on that. And that's 15 additional full-time employees.
Gotcha.
We're a staff of about 20 people, part-time, full-time mix. We seriously cannot do what we do without volunteers. That's not just a tagline. That's not just a slogan. It's just the truth.
Yeah.
Especially in the myriad of ways that food
especially after seeing all y'all do. I mean, that's y'all need help to do all of this.
And so it's that time of year. We love for people to come in and volunteer. We love for families to come together, organizations, school groups, whatever. There's always something to do. Since my boys were little, when they started here in the soup kitchen, and I'm allowed to tell this story, my youngest had to stand on a milk crate to be eye level to give out dessert. I have his permission to talk.
Oh, cool.
He's 19 now. But
and you're his mom.
And I'm his mom, so I'm allowed to tell that story. But that is something that we are very intentional about, is we want to make sure that we have opportunities for everyone. Mm-hmm. There is so much value in families serving together. I mean, it's had a significant impact on my family, obviously, because I'm still here doing this.
Well, I really appreciate you showing us around.
You're very welcome. Let's do that hunger-free holidays list.
Let's jump into it.
That helps provide holiday meals for folks in need.
That's hunger-free holidays?
Hunger-free holidays. And so those are basically holiday meal in a bag, a protein, cranberry sauce, green beans, muffin mix, cornbread, all of those things that will go into the bag. And so it is a portable holiday meal. So that will be wonderful.
That wraps up this Community Focus Friday here in Jackson, Tennessee at RIFA. Really good organization. They're doing awesome stuff over here. Thanksgiving, Christmas is around the corner. Help people out. Bring your stuff to RIFA and they will put it to good use. Until next Community Focus Friday, this is Nathan signing off.